Nosocomial pneumonia is a type of pneumonia that originates and is acquired inside of the hospital setting. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Pneumonia is an infection that causes inflammation in the lungs and results in fluid buildup, fever, cough, and difficulty breathing. It's caused by a variety of different organisms, including viruses, bacteria, fungi, and even parasites in some cases. When this disease is contracted inside of the hospital, as previously mentioned, it is referred to as nosocomial pneumonia. The other types of pneumonia include community-acquired pneumonia, ventilator-associated pneumonia, and aspiration pneumonia. The specific type of pneumonia is classified according to how the patient acquires the disease. For example, community-acquired pneumonia is when the patient gets it outside of the hospital setting. Ventilator-associated pneumonia is when it's acquired while the patient is on the mechanical ventilator. And aspiration pneumonia is acquired when a patient aspirates bacteria into the lungs, usually from food, saliva, or stomach acid. But for this video, we're specifically focusing on nosocomial pneumonia. For it to classify as this type, the patient must acquire the infection more than 48 hours after being admitted to the hospital. This is how we can differentiate it from community-acquired pneumonia. A pneumonia infection can vary from mild to severe, depending on the patient's signs and symptoms. Some examples include a productive cough, fever and chills, tachypnea, shortness of breath, chest pain, diaphoresis, fatigue, and cyanosis. Being able to recognize the signs and symptoms is important for the diagnosis, treatment, and patient outcome. With that said, in general, nosocomial pneumonia is often more severe because usually the patient is already sick enough to require hospital admission. In some cases, these patients are more susceptible due to an already weakened immune system. Nosocomial pneumonia is often spread to the patient by healthcare workers when they pass germs from their hands, clothes, or instruments. This can be avoided with proper hand washing, PPE, and other safety measures. Now let's talk about the treatment. Pneumonia in general should be treated on a case-by-case basis. However, some of the most common treatment methods include the following: antibiotic medications, oxygen therapy, bed rest, airway clearance therapy, hyperinflation therapy, and fluid management. Each patient may require different treatment modalities depending on their signs and symptoms. In severe cases, intubation and mechanical ventilation may be indicated. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was useful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I will drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.